Hey guys, what's going on? Good morning, good morning, good morning. It is Friday and it is going to be a great day today. I had a crazy show that I watched on Netflix the other night called The Social Dilemma. If you have not had a chance to watch that, get on and check that out. I'm telling you, more than anything, I think what it did is it brought things to my attention, more to light about how the human brain works. And how social media has amplified some things that we struggle with as a society more than anything. You know, technology is a tool. That's all it is. It is a tool that we can use to our benefit or to our detriment. And it's amazing because that show, that documentary about social media and really how it started, what its intentions were, and how it's just grown beyond just simply due to all the information that society puts into these algorithms and how they've grown. It's phenomenal. But really, I'll be honest with you, if you get a chance to watch it, keep in mind one thing that it brought to my attention was that, once again, realizing social media and technology is a tool. It's not wrong. It's not bad. But when it is used the wrong way, just like money, just like guns, just like ourselves and our emotions, right? When we use these things the right way, they can be highly beneficial to ourselves and to society. So keep that in mind as you're watching it. But overall, the biggest thing that it helped me to realize really is the deep down ultimate human condition of negativity, pessimism. You know, these algorithms for social media and how they know what keeps our attention, and what keeps our attention is how they make their money at the end of the day. And unfortunately, we are defaulted and we are driven towards negativity in our lives. It's easier. It's what the news is always talking about because it's what gets people's attention. And so what social media has done is it's like banner ads, right? And think of it more as the negative thoughts in your mind are like banner ads online. For those of you that don't know how those retargeting ads work, it's like when you're looking at shoes on Amazon, or you're looking at that house on Zillow or whatever, and you click on it. And then next thing you know, other websites you go to, they have the banners that product will show up, right? Well, our negative thoughts are the exact same way. If we come across a negative thought, or we sit there and we see something negatively, or we say something negatively about ourselves, right? Or even about someone else, but more importantly about ourselves. You know, oh, I'm not pretty. Oh, I'm not handsome. I'm not strong enough. I'm stupid. You know, all these negative thoughts are like clicking on those banner ads. And what happens is, even though we might not be on that website anymore, we might move on from that, right? We might be playing with our kids, or we might be having good food at dinner, and we're like, wow, this is delicious. Guess what banner ad pops up on that webpage? Yeah. But remember, you're stupid, so you don't really know the right thing. Well, remember, I mean, this might be good food, but you know, it's not gonna last. And next thing we know, we click on these banner ads, right? We grab a hold of those thoughts, and those grow. Those are gonna continue to follow around with us. And social media has amplified this issue in our society, where we say something negative and we post something negative. But what ends up happening is other people see that. And the way these algorithms work is it's going to lead you towards the things that you are posting about, that you're commenting about, that you're liking. And so it just reinstigates that belief that you have. And then it just grows and grows, and it does it subtly over time. But next thing you know, years of your life are gone that you've spent on social media, years of validating that negative belief system in your life, to where now, years down the road, you're depressed. You think your life is absolutely horrible and terrible, and you've had things that have been reiterating that belief system because it's what you've been sharing. And like I said, it's those retargeting ads in our brains, even. Those negative thoughts that are just being reiterated by those things around us, by what we say, by what we do. So this is exciting stuff, though, because this means that we can actually turn this around to be a positive and a good thing in our lives. So if it can take people down such a dark path, starting very small and just having these ads follow us around, guess what the positive side of it can do? You are beautiful. You are smart. You are loving. You are compassionate. You have joy in your life. You have thankfulness. And we start clicking on different banner ads, right? Once again, the technology is not bad. It's just a tool. But what would happen in your life if you were to start clicking on all the positive tools and all the positive thoughts and all the getting rid of those banner ads? Remember, because it took so much time to build up, it's going to take time to change that. So it's not going to happen overnight. But imagine how powerful it can be in your life if you were to change those negative banner ads in your mind and your thoughts into positive ones. So I, more than anything, was brought, this was brought to my attention through this, the Social Dilemma on Netflix. There's a lot in, there's things in there I just disagree with. There's things in there I do agree with. It's a buffet, so just take what you can get out of it. But I can tell you that one piece, that one nugget that I got out of it was worth the hour and a half to watch it. So take a look at it, watch it. We need to start waking up in here and in here, and start realizing how our daily actions, the small, insignificant things that don't seem like a big deal, have shaped our futures, have shaped who we are as people, and social media has just, it's amplifying those issues. And so, once again, social media is not bad. It's done a lot of good, and it has helped a lot of people, and it has saved lives in certain instances. But the opposite of that is also true. It can also rip us apart, it can tear us down, and it'll do it so subtly because it's done through these algorithms, just like our subconscious mind is our algorithm. It's a physical algorithm used to be able to feed us our beliefs and what's already inside of us, right? Because it wants to get our attention, and what gets our attention is what we believe. So let's change what we believe about ourselves. Let's change what we believe about society. Let's take those negative thoughts, make them positive. Let's take all of the self-destructive habits. Let's be aware of them so that we can start making different ones, so that years down the road, you can look back and go, wow, I didn't realize how far I had gone. So let's wake up. Let's start today. Right now, I want you to comment, and I want you to say something positive about yourself, that you are beautiful, that you are smart, that you have things to offer this world, that people around you need you, because that is the actual truth. Don't forget it.